Hello, and thank you for pressing that play button to watch this video very, very quickly. I'm Clive from Clive's Art. There are other playlists available for you. Just need to click on these buttons below and subscribe if you haven't already subscribed for regular updates and uploads. And you can join me on Facebook where I give regular updates again and give you little snippets of things before they are actually published. So thank you very much. Please join my channel and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hello and welcome again. I'm Clive from Clive's Art and we're in the mixed media lesson. As you can see behind me, I've used a heavy structure paste, modelling paste, to actually put the flowers onto the canvas. And that, if you haven't seen that, have a look at my playlist, and you'll need to watch the one before this. But basically what I've done, I prepped the canvas, drew some flowers, put some modelling paste on there, let it harden for a few days, and I am now in the process of mixing some pigment or paint to match the colour. Now, before this, I'm going to be using snippets of this for my quick tips section. So, ever mix paint? Have you ever used one of these colour wheels? Check out my links below and there is a video there to tell you how this thing works. But it's always handy to have in the studio, especially if you're not too familiar with primary, secondary and tertiary colours and how to mix these different colours together, how white works with the paint and how black works with the paint and how your grey tones work. Anyway, I'm not going into that. But have one to hand, they're always handy and they're only a few pounds. The other thing I've got is an old picture frame, and I've put, obviously the glass is in there, and I've blanked it off with white. I put some masking tape around. I use this for practicing with the airbrush, but I also like mixing my paints on glass. Don't know why, I just do. You don't have to do that, you mix them any way you want. Okay, so this project, I was given the brief of flowers in these colours. Yes, again, you've heard me say it, it's a pillowcase, so I need to match these colours. So I need to get a, and I said I need again, when we've got my little selection tools or cards that I use for putting over colours to match the colours to. Don't know how to use these, don't know how to make them, that's not a problem. I'll show you how to use them now, but if you want to know how I made them, check out my quick tips video. Yes, it's all on there. So I'm going to get one of these, I'm going to put it onto my bench, I'm going to fold up my pillowcase like that. I've also got my trusty little squirty bottle which I use for misting down my paintings. Well, I mean, stopping the skin from forming, because you know this, the skin forms in acrylics and that's why they dry so fast. Check out my other playlists and that'll explain. I'm just misting down the glass and I'm going to let that set there just for a couple of seconds while I'm talking to you. And I got my other trusty tool, this kitchen roll. One of the best tools you can ever have in the studio, and they're very, very inexpensive. So I'm going to put that on my easel where it belongs. I've got a little blade here that I've taken out of one of my craft knives. It doesn't need to be sharp. You just need to be able to go over the surface of the glass, if you're using glass, that is, and then just to clean off any lumps of paint. I don't want any contamination. I'm getting my kitchen roll. And I'm cleaning my mixing frame off. Now, if you're going to be mixing paints, you can mix them obviously on your wet palette or whatever palette you mix your paints on. You carry on; it's not a problem at all. I like mixing on glass because it's just one of them things I've got used to in the bin. And the other thing I'm going to be using is I'm not going to be using the paintbrush because if you mix with a paintbrush, you can push the paint all the way up into the ferrule, and is a nightmare if you don't clean your brushes properly. I will be doing another quick tip video on brush care, so I'm not even going to go into that. That'll be covered again. But there's a couple of different palette knives you can get. You can get big palette knives, you can get proper angled palette knives with palette brush. Paintings. You can use little trowels for DIY. So, and you can get little plastic ones as well. They're all basically the same. But you pick whichever one that you find you are comfortable with for mixing acrylic paint. Now, I have got one here, and that's my, is that my favourite one? No, I'm not organised today. I got a very small one there, which is a number 5, and I've also got a number 3. And these were inexpensive, they weren't, I think I got them in a craft shop somewhere, so they're only a few pounds, don't need to spend a lot of money. No. So, as you can see, they haven't been very well maintained or cleaned, so I need to clean them and give myself a slap on the wrist, because I'm trying to show you the correct way of doing something and I don't do it myself. But there we are. It encourages me to do the proper things in the proper manner. So we're all set up. We've got our palette knives. We've got a little bit of water in our mister bottle. We've got our pillowcase or photograph or reference photo or whatever we want. And we need to pick a section of this now to get our first colour mixed. Now, this painting is going to be primarily blue, and it's going to have a bit of pearlescence in it. Pearlescence, well, it's like a shimmery effect, and you can buy that in tubes and bottles, and I will show as we go on through this lesson how I actually mix that in with my pigment. Okay, so looking down onto the board, we have got our pillowcase in place, and we've got our little card with a hole in it. There's a dark side and a white side, so a bit like Star Wars really. But I'm going to use primarily the white side, and I'm going to place that over a blue that I've selected, and I'm going to be trying to match that as close as I possibly can. That's the colour in the centre that I want to match. Again, if I want a lighter colour, then I can go over to a lighter spot, and if I want a little bit of brown or whatever that colour is, it looks like I don't know what that is. What is it? It looks like a yellow ochre type of colour. I don't know. Who cares? But there's a dark colour. There's a mid-tone range colour. There's a very light tealy type of colour. There's a lot of green in that I can see. I haven't got my proper glasses on. But what I'm going to do now, I'm going to look through my selection of paints and see if I can get a close match to that out of the tube directly before we start adjusting it with value and that type of thing. We can add a bit of white, or we can add more blue, or whatever. We need to have a look what I've got in the drawer, and then I'll get back to you and see if we can match these colours, and then we'll decide what colour we're going to put where on the painting. So looking at my selection of blues that I have in my drawer, as you can see, I've got quite a few there. And I got my other eyes on. I got two sets of glasses. Get them my age, you need them. I've decided I got a Ceylon blue there, which is a Windsor. I'm mentioning names just for the sake of it, but just to let you know that I do use different brands, but I'm not promoting anything. I don't get paid for this in any way, shape or form. But if there are people out there who want me to promote their products, I'm more than happy to do that for you. Just get in touch via my email. Okay. It's worth a try. Ceylon Blue, and this is made by Winsor & Newton. It's a Galleria range. It's a AA permanence, and it's a Series 1 colour. Okay. The other colour I've got, again, is another Winsor & Newton. But this is an ultramarine blue. I got other tubes, but that's just a little bit of paint I want to use up, and I've got a Prussian blue. Now this has got carbon black and ultramarine blue in it, because I know how Prussian blue is made, And this is a, it's Dylan and Roney, and it's a System 3 original acrylic, and it's got a, it's got a 3-star permanent. So A's, stars, all basically the same. It just says that they're fixed in light, basically. They don't fade. So, and I've got a Liquitex basic range. This is a 22mm tube, and this colour is a light blue permanent. It doesn't look as if I've ever used much of that, so I'm going to give that a shot. I've also got a primary blue, which is a Basics, Liquitex Basics, and that's the only range that I can actually find primary blue in. Yes, there we are, that's why I don't use much of it. However, and I got another Liquitex Basics. I think I had these for Christmas 1 year. They were in a big box of 36. Yes, they were, and I think they were purchased from Hobby Lobby or Hobbycraft. But somewhere like that anyway. I'm not promoting any products. Unless you want me to. Okay.
Liquitex Basics, yes. Very good paint.
Cobalt Blue. And I'm going to use, I think, maybe a little bit of titanium white. There we are. There's a Galleria titanium white there, 120mm tube. And I've got, what's that? That's a Payne's Grey. And our Payne's Grey is mixed with ultramarine blue and carbon black. So you don't have to buy tubes of this. You can mix your own. But there we are. I'm going to use a little bit of Mars black. And I've got my shades and I got my values and I've got some different types of blue, and I'm going to go to the palette now and I'm going to have a bit of fun and I'm going to see if I can get these colours mixed as best I can. And guess what? What I'm going to put them in once I mix them is these little paper cups. Now you keep hearing me talking about these, and they do come from a restaurant, and they're not free. But they are there, and I sometimes just go to pick one up, and I just pick up four, and it just happens like that sometimes. And then before I know it, I got a little stack. But I'm sure we can use other things. There's other things available on the market. But these are lovely because they're wax paper, and they can sit on your wet palette, and the paint stays in there forever before it goes dry, especially if you put a bit of greaseproof paper over the top. So that's a little tip for you. So I'm going to mix up some paint. I'll take you through the first colour, and then I'll just put the video on and just speed it up a little bit. You can see me mix it. I'm going to be using the same process of elimination. I'm going to be adding a little white or whatever, and a couple of different blues together. I'm going to try and get these values as close as I possibly can through looking at my little colour stick, and you'll see me just put in little bits of test paint marks on there, just so I can match it up. So I'm going to stop that for the moment. I'm just going to have a look at my canvas, take 10 minutes out, and just decide what I'm going to put where by looking at it with the pillowcase next to it. Okay, I'm just looking at this pillowcase and deciding mainly what colour the main flowers are going to be, and I'm looking at the background as well, because if you're going to put if the flowers are going to be a slightly darker colour, obviously there's going to be a couple of different tones in there, a couple of shades of colour, or values I should say. You really do need to place them on a lighter background, because it'll show the depth up a little bit more. But if you want lighter flowers, then it's always better to go slightly darker at the back. Now, don't argue with me. I just know for a fact that Leonardo da Vinci said that if you've got a white object on a dark background, it shows up better, and a dark object on a white background, it shows up better. So I'm not going to argue with Leonardo da Vinci. So I'm using that principle in this painting, and I'll add this like a light browny, possibly yellow ochre colour. I'll see if I can match something as near as that, just to put into the centre of the flowers there. Yeah, so we'll get back to the mixing bench and see what we can do about that. Thank you very much for watching that episode. If you want to check out my links, please check out the links below and subscribe. Yes, if you haven't already subscribed, press that button there, the little red button you'll find underneath. If you can't find that button for any particular reason, scroll down to my descriptions and at the bottom you'll see a link for subscriptions. And on the way, read the description itself, and there are links there for my other playlists which you will find interesting, because I've got well over 130 plus videos now, so there's plenty there to keep you going. I do question and answers, etc, etc. I'm not covering that now, but just check out the playlists. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so, and thanks for watching this step-by-step lesson.